I'm going to show you how to make a cool search bar animation using PowerDirector. Let's find some useful information. I'm going to have an image in the background when I do my search, so I'm going to go ahead and left click on this, hold down my left mouse. I'm going to drag this down to track one. Then I'm going to click on the duration button here because I want to change it to 10 seconds. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. Now I'm going to click on Fix Enhance, and I want to go ahead and make this a little darker. So I'm going to bring my brightness down so that when I have the animation and the text on the screen, it kind of stands out. Now I want to go ahead and add a search box. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Color Boards. I'm going to go down to white. I'm going to left click on it and I'm going to drag it down to track two. I'm going to click on duration again because I want it to match the duration of the original image. I'll go ahead and click on OK. Now I'm going to go over here to tools and I'm going to go to mask designer. So I need to create a mask to make the middle of this square invisible and make it into a search box. So I'm going to scroll all the way up to the top and I'm going to click on this square. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on invert mask. Now I need to go ahead and change the scale of this mask. So I'm going to go down to mask scale. And where it says maintain aspect ratio, I'm going to uncheck that. And then you need to change your width and your height. So I already know the width and the height that I'm going to use. You might need to change yours up. And then you want to go ahead and click on OK. Then you want to double left click on the color board to open up the PIP designer. And we're going to go to the scale section here. Once again, we're going to uncheck where it says maintain aspect ratio. And we're going to change our width. And we're going to go ahead and change our height. And we'll go ahead and click on OK. And we got our search box. Now we need to go ahead and add our microphone and our magnifying glass. So we're going to click on media content. And as you can see, I got a microphone right here. I'm going to go ahead and left click, hold down my left mouse, and I'm going to drag it down to track three. Then I'm going to click on duration because guess what? It needs to be the same duration, right? I'll type that in and I'll go ahead and click on OK. Now we want to double left click on this to open up the PIP designer. And we want to go to scale. And we're going to change our scale and bring it down so that it'll fit inside of the box. For this one, I already know what I need. So I'm just going to type it in. And then we need to change the position. We want to move it all the way over to the left. Once again, I know the position that I want. So for the position, I'm going to go to X and I'll type that in. And now I'll click on OK. So we need to do the same thing with our magnifying glass. So we'll hold on our left mouse. We'll drag this down. You guys should know the routine by now, okay? Duration. 10 seconds. OK. Then we're going to double left click on the magnifying glass. It'll open up that PIP designer. Want to change our width again. Once again, you can use these nodes here. Hold down your left mouse and just drag it to make it smaller. I don't need to do that. I'm going to type in the parameter that I want and hit enter. And then for the position, once again, you can drag it left, right, whatever you want to do with it. I'm just going to type in those positions that I want. And now I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. Next, we need to add our text. So we're going to go ahead and left click on the title room. And we're going to drag the default text to track 5. We're going to go to duration. Change that to 10 seconds and click on OK. Now we'll double left click the title to open up the title designer. And we're going to double left click in this text box to select all of this text. And we're going to change our font size to the font we want. I want 24. And then we'll go ahead and type in the words that we want. And then we're going to go ahead and place our cursor over the text until we see crosshairs. Hold on our left mouse and we'll drag the text to the position that we want. Now you can use your arrow keys on your keyboard if you need to make any adjustments to the text. Now we don't want the text to start right when the title shows up. So I'm going to go ahead and place my cursor over here to the edge of this timeline. And I'm going to hold down my left mouse button. I'm going to drag it into 2 seconds. That means it'll be a 2 second delay for the text to actually show up on the screen. Now I want to go ahead and add my animation that will make the text show up like it's being typed. So I'm going to go to animation. I'm going to go to in animation. And I'm going to scroll down until I find wipe right. I'm going to left click on that. And this is the end of the animation. And I don't want it to be so long. I want it to be a little bit faster so that it seems like it's being typed pretty quickly on the screen. So I'm going to place my cursor over this bar, which is the end of the animation. Hold down my left mouse and I'm going to drag it in to where I want the animation to stop. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And now we can go ahead and play this back. Your search for a search bar effect is over. I have a smorgasbord of PowerDirector title effect tutorials to satisfy your needs. If you want to see how to make a retro computer text effect, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.